Hi everyone, this is Sunera from Itsy Bitsy and I'm here to show you how you can make this gorgeous rose basket card using some awesome supplies from Itsy Bitsy. So let me tell you the supplies that you're going to need for this card. Of course you're going to need some red cardstock, you're going to need the Itsy Bitsy swirly rose die, some awesome glitter strips, I've used the vintage theme. If you want to add a ribbon, you need some ribbon, and finally you're going to need some white cardstock cut into this shape. The shape template will be on our blog. So now let's get started. First I'm going to take the card and I'm going to glue a strip of adhesive right onto the top of what I want to be the top of the basket. I've cut the glitter strips into a number of little smaller strips and I'm just placing one at one end and then placing another one perpendicular to that underneath it. And as you can see, I'm constantly putting a little piece of glitter strips perpendicular to the top strip at even intervals, because this, what I really want to create is a woven effect. So as I add each strip, it's going to be one over, one under, and so doing, I will create the woven effect. So I've got all these glitter strips. I'm just placing them, leaving a gap for their counterparts that are going to come once these are glued down. So I'm just about reaching the end of the first row of this basket. It's looking pretty good. And I'm going to finish off with a final adhesive on the top. Next, what I'm going to do is glue the spaces in between. I'm going to glue perpendicular strips again, making sure that I only glue the top. I only add adhesive to the top of these strips, and I'm placing them on top of the horizontal strip that I have just glued down. So it looks pretty straightforward. I mean, I don't know. I suppose if you were not watching this, it may not at all make sense what I'm saying, but considering that you're watching it while I speak, you understand what I'm doing. This is really the most complex part of making a woven basket, the woven effect for any card. After that, it's really easy peasy. After you glue the final end together, it really becomes super simple. So now to create this woven effect, I'm now just going to lift up every alternate strip and just place it, fold it back so that it stays out of the way. And when it's out of the way, I'm just going to glue another horizontal strip. It's really as simple as that. It's not like I'm not going to be like threading one into the other. I've just glued this down. And when that's glued down, I bring back the pieces that I folded upwards, I just bring them back down. And here I've got my second row of weaving. Now I'm gonna do the same procedure with the strips that I did not fold back the last time. I'm gonna do the same thing, fold it back, every alternate strip, fold it back in place, add another horizontal strip, glue it on top, and it's now the third row of weaving has been done. Doesn't it look nice? So now I'm going to be doing that for pretty much the rest of the basket. So I'm going to put this video on super fast speed so that you can see exactly what I'm doing, at the same time not die of boredom because it's really repetitive steps. At some point during this whole thing, you need to trim off the extra strips so that you don't waste your time gluing and weaving when there isn't any card underneath. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm just trimming off whatever residue strips are remaining on the side. And once that's done, I'm just going to continue with my weaving action. I glue a strip down, fold them back down, fold the other ones back up, glue another strip down, and so on and so forth until my entire basket is well woven together. I guess towards the end of the whole thing, it's going to be a little trickier than usual because You got to make sure that the ends look really neat and clean. So this is the last strip I'm putting down, and I'm just gonna be particularly careful. So I've slowed down the video so you can see that I've made a lot of effort to, you know, be particularly careful, because you want the end result to be a nicely finished clean card. You might also notice that these glitter strips, I've not, you know, they come in varying shades of the same color. So they're not all, I mean, there are about three or four different shades. So they're actually all little bit different shades, and I've made it a point to use the different shades so that, you know, because that's kind of how, you know, cane or straw or anything is. When you actually see a basket, it's not like every strand is the same shade, and the glitter strips allowed me to create to execute that exact effect, because they themselves come in such varying shades. So with that, I've completed the woven basket and now I'm gonna take a moment to show you a close hand how it looks. See, doesn't it look gorgeous? And I mean, the glitter is absolutely lovely. It offers such a shiny, pretty effect. I'm so pleased. Now I'm going to get started on the roses. To do that, I'm going to take a piece of red cardstock and use my Itsy Bitsy Swirly Rose Die to run it through the big shot. It gets through really quick. And then that's all the big shotting I'm going to be doing today. It's everything else is, you know, without the big shot. So, you know, you can do the same project without roses, with regular Itsy Bitsy flowers, if you don't have a big shot and you don't want to buy a cutting die. Now, whenever I do roses or any kind of flower, it really makes a great effect to kind of add a dark tinge to each of the petals. Roses, when you actually see them, you will see this kind of graduated color. So it's really easy to do. Just take an ink pad, dip your sponge dauber in it, and just smudge a little bit on the edges. For this particular flower, I'm doing it on both sides, and it's almost like you won't really notice it, but it is an effect that gets that yields the desired benefits. So I'm just about wrapping up with the distressing, and now I'm going to get to work with actually creating my rose. Making roses with this die cut is really simple. You just have to roll the entire strip, you know, into one big spiral. Just keep rolling in a random order. You're not trying to do it in any particular way. You're not trying to mold the petals in any particular way, nothing. At this stage of the rose creation process, all you're doing is just rolling it as if you were rolling like a roll of tape or a roll of ribbon. You're just rolling it. At the very end, put a little bit of glue from your glue gun and glue it down so that the rose stays, all the spiral stays in place. Now it's time to do the molding. To do that, take each petal and fold it, or rather curl it back. I'm using a piercing tool from Itsy Bitsy for that, but you can use any thin tool, you know, an embossing tool or a very thin pen or whatever you have, to just curl just a little bit, whatever you can, each of the petals, just curl them backwards. It gives a feeling of a very open and luscious rose. See, here's a close-up of the rose. Don't you think it's pretty and grand and luscious? Now, for this project, I've used about 16 or 17 of these roses. I'm not quite sure, I lost track. And I'm just gonna now arrange them on this on top of the basket basically I want to cover everything. So a good tip for you could be to put the base, I mean the space which the red is, the roses are covering, you can cover that with red cardstock so that you know, you don't see any white. I also wanted to add a little card, and I wanted the card to sort of pop out of the basket just like a card would in a flower bouquet. So I've just cut that out with the Itsy Bitsy Victorian Labels die. Now, once I know exactly where I want everything placed, I'm starting from the center and I'm just adding a little dollop of glue on each, at the bottom of each rose, and placing it where I intended it to be. I want the card to sort of pop out of the basket, so I'm going to sort of insert it between two roses which have been glued in place. And then to make sure it stays where it is, I've just put a line of glue at the bottom. So this is the card with all the roses done. So now I'm going to add a ribbon and I'm going to show you how I tie a perfect bow. The first step to tying a perfect bow is to make sure the ribbon is adhered in place. Otherwise, you're going to have it moving around and that's a variable you don't really need to deal with. Now to actually tie the bow, put the left side ribbon over the right side one such that the left one ends up coming straight down and the right one ends up going straight up. Then keeping your finger in place, make a loop with what is now your right hand ribbon, and now pull the left hand one over that and tuck it inside the little space. That's what will make your bow coming out straight. Now, as you can see, nobody's bow looks perfect the minute they're done. You have to tweak it and adjust it, tighten, loosen, pull, release. Definitely create a nice loop for each of the little bow components. And also what matters is the material of the ribbon. I'm using this lovely gross grain from Itsy Bitsy. It really doesn't slip much and it stays where you want it to stay. And that's why the bow looks really, really, really good. I'm happy with that now. All I need to do is trim off the tails a bit. I don't want a very long tail because the basket, I want the basket weaving to be seen. So I'm just going to cut it quite short. I think the other side can be shorter. So I'm just going to cut that as well a little more. Don't you think the ribbon really complements the whole card? I think it does, and act frankly, very few cards of mine don't have a bow, as Dr. Sonia very often says. And this is a final look at the project, starting with the basket woven out of glitter strips, a nice bright bow, and bountiful roses oozing out of a basket. If only I would get roses like this on Valentine's Day. Hint, hint, nudge, nudge, hubby dearest. And that brings us to the end of another tutorial here at Itsy Bitsy. I really hope you found this useful. It was really fun for me. And stay tuned to many more tutorials from all of us here at Itsy Bitsy. Bye!